This is part four of adding and subtracting rational expressions that have different denominators, and we'll just be doing more examples. Here's an example. 7 over 2m plus 20 plus 70 over m squared minus 100. Remember, we begin by factoring the denominator. All right, so for the first one, we could take out a factor of 2 and get 2 times m plus 10. And remember, we're probably going to have to multiply that by something to get a common denominator, so let's leave a little space there. And for the second one, we have a difference of 2 squares, so that'll be m plus 10 times m minus 10. And again, we might have to multiply that by something in the numerator and denominator as well. We're not sure. All right, so what we do is we start with the first denominator and we look over to the right at the other denominators, if there's more than one, and see if it needs anything. Let's see. It has to have an m plus 10, which it already has, and it needs an m minus 10. So that's what I need to multiply the numerator and denominator of the first fraction by, m minus 10 over m minus 10. And this then is the least common denominator, 2 times m plus 10 times n minus 10. So now we look at the second denominator and we see we're missing the 2. We've got the m plus 10 and the m minus 10, so we need to multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. All right, so now it's all over a common denominator, each of them, each fraction has the same denominator, so I can put them all over that denominator. 2 times m plus 10 times m minus 10. Now in each numerator, I need to multiply if possible. So I have 7 times m minus 10. I'm going to have to do the distributive property. That's 7m minus 70 plus, and in the second fraction, I'll have the 70 times 2, which is 140. So we still have to simplify the numerator by adding the like terms. So that gives me 7m plus 70 all over 2 times m plus 10 times m minus 10. All right, the last thing we need to do is see if we could factor the numerator to see if anything cancels. And we can take a 7 out of the numerator. So we have 7 times m plus 10 over 2 times m plus 10 times m minus 10. And then we see that the m plus 10s cancel. So it did cancel when we did that. So what do we end up with? The numerator, we still have 7 in the numerator, and in the denominator, we have 2 times m minus 10. So you could leave your answer like this, or if you want, you could multiply out the denominator and write 2m minus 20. That's up to you. All right, here's the next problem. If you want, you could try it on your own first. All right, so we're going to begin by factoring the denominators, and in fact, both of them are already factored, aren't they? You can't factor them any further. So it'd be easier to start this one by sort of leaving space right next to that first fraction. So let's just scooch this over a little bit. And let's see what we need to multiply the numerators and with the denominators by, so we have a least common denominator. So if it looks over to the right, the only thing it doesn't have is that 2x plus 1. So I need to multiply the numerator and denominator of this fraction by 2x plus 1. Now, remember, the first numerator has a 2x plus 5 in the numerator. You must put a parentheses around that so that you could do the FOIL method here. All right, for the second fraction now, I had a 2x plus 1, it needs an x minus 3. So that's what we're going to have to multiply each fraction by to get a common denominator. So now it's all going to be over that least common denominator, x minus 3 times 2x plus 1. And in the first fraction, we need to do the FOIL method or any other method for multiplying two binomials. So I'm going to go ahead and use the FOIL method. 2x times 2x is 4x squared. 2x times 1 is plus 2x. The inner terms will be plus 10x, and the last term plus 5. Moving on to the second fraction. 5x times x is 5x squared, and then I have 5x times minus 3, that is negative 15x. Now, in this problem, there was a plus sign between the two fractions, which makes it easier. If it was a minus sign, all the signs would change here. So be careful if there's a minus sign between the two fractions. All right, so now let's go ahead and simplify the numerator by adding like terms. We have 4x squared plus 5x squared. That's going to be 9x squared. And then let's do the x terms. We have 2x plus 10x, which is 12x, minus 15x. That's going to be minus 3x. And then I only have one constant term. It's plus 5. And that's over x minus 3 times 2x plus 1. Let me see if we could factor the numerator, and actually it doesn't factor. So you would try it, but if it doesn't factor, then of course you just have to keep with what you have, and that's your answer. It's up to you if you want to multiply the denominators out. You don't need to. I would just leave it factored. One last step you have to do. All right, here's another one. 3 over x plus h minus 1 over x. All right, we have to make sure that each denominator is factored, and in fact, it is, because x plus h is different than x, right? So you can't factor either of them. And again, it might be easier, instead of writing another line, just kind of move this over a little bit. So I'm going to put the minus 1 over x a little bit to the right. So I can see what I need to multiply each fraction by to get a common denominator. So in the first denominator, I need this factor of x. Remember, that's different than the x inside the parentheses. I mean, it's a different factor. X plus h is a different factor than x. So I can multiply this by x over x. And in the second fraction, I need an x plus h in the denominator. Remember, that's a whole quantity. So that's why I put parentheses around it. Okay, so the least common denominator is going to be x times x plus h. I've made it so they both have the same denominator. Now, in the numerator of the first fraction, I need to multiply out the 3 times x. That's 3x. And you have to be careful for this next one. I'm actually subtracting 1 times x plus h. Okay, so I'm going to show that step. I'm subtracting. I don't really have to write the 1 in front of it, but I'm subtracting the x plus h, that whole quantity. Remember, you're going to have to distribute that minus sign. So we have 3x minus x minus h all over x times x plus h. So in the numerator, if I do combine like terms, I'll get 2x minus h all over x times x plus h. And you can't factor the numerator, so nothing cancels. So that will be our answer. And if you want to go on to the next video, we'll just work with more examples. There are lots and lots of problems you should try till you really get down adding and subtracting with rational expressions.